So I request Deepshika Sudhakar Mishra.
Here it goes. This piece is a love poetry. This piece I'm going to recite today is a love poetry. Poetry about my love for my vagina. Alert, alert. Did I just say that out aloud? Creating in your rightly rational and politically correct head a misogynistic doubt. Or did I make a mistake? Did I just make a mistake splashing freezing cold water in your forever shut eyes, keeping them wide and awake? This is a letter to you, coming from an Indian woman, from Lakshmi, from Pooja, and from Savitri, socially adopted as the sacred cow, internally dying to become a hyena. Dear vagina, how have you been doing? Under the manhood of males, imprisoned with accuracy and security behind the societal bars of patriarchy, chauvinism and misogyny in jails. I know. I do know when every time your name is taken in hushed tones and low voices, you feel guilty. You feel guilty, don't you? Just like a criminal who has escaped his sentence, or a murderer who has killed an entire tribe. Or a thief who has stolen invaluable jewels. I know they show no chivalry. I know you're scared. I know time and again you're scared when you suffer from infections and diseases you can't utter a word about. When you bleed 2,400 days in a lifetime, feeling cramps days and days out. When you are stared upon. When you are stared upon, shaved upon, drugged upon, flavored upon, inserted objects upon, leaving burnouts. When you are nicknamed with names that make me hide my face in the corners of this male-dominated, spiritual, substandard society, I can't let a sigh out. They say you're gentle. They say you are gentle like the touch me nots, like the pecks of feathers, like the hugs of cotton balls. And maybe you are, but it must hurt. It must hurt when the feather takes all the poundings from the drilling hammer and a mere stroke right there in his balls makes him shimmer. They say you are a temple. They say you are a temple, a home for the goddess of womanhood, for the mistress of customs and the creator of femininity. And maybe you are. Maybe you are. But the idols must be loved and lauded, adored and admired, chanted and cheered, bowed down and doted down to, magnified and sanctified, venerated and worshipped. Satisfied and served, but you, my dear little darling, you are just a shame. S-H-A-M-E, shame. Because you're supposed to be rosy pink as the petals of newly formed little red roses. You are supposed to be smooth and transparent and lucid as the shining, shimmering glass window panes. You are supposed to be tight and flexible just in the right amount. Wild and virgin, suitable enough for the men to feed their gigantic egos. You are supposed to please men's best friends, no different to gadgets or clothing or properties or mobile phones, to feed their materialistic pleasures. You're supposed to be my success and character portfolio. Because you're the degrees of my high school and graduation, you're the gold medals of my sports competitions, you're the mini skirts from my shopping sprees, you're the living that I earn by working 24/7. You're the count of men I loved and I dated and I slept with, you're the position at my workplaces, you're the court's degree of my loyalty, you're the voice screaming on the public stages. I have 37.2 trillion cells. I have 37.2 trillion cells, 206 bones, 642 skeletal muscles, 32 body organs, 5 operative senses and brain. Because my brain decides what salary I get, which men I deserve, what ranking I possess, what points my character gets, and not the quantum of penises that have pierced my descending walls and left me bleeding. And you, my darling, you are only one single part of my whole. And so I will love you in all the four seasons, but for all the right reasons. You crave for my love, don't you? You crave for my love. And even when I want to touch you and caress you and feel you and please you, for that to happen, it will take 10 more centuries. To me, it seems like a sarcasm, because this world does not understand the meaning of female orgasms. So till then, just be the pussy and be the balls. Sincerely, women. Thank you.